Ooh, the uber-powerful current gun. This video is in response to my friends who believe I don't play video games because I don't play League of Legends. This is Nova 3. The campaign doesn't have much to offer, but you can expect lots of mayhem on the multiplayer matches, unlike any other in the App Store. I must warn you, though, the file size is 1.69 gigabytes. Now, I just randomly picked up my iPad and started recording. All this action, like those two who shot each other at the same time, happens all the time. Now, this game felt really balanced. You don't want to feel too sure of yourself just because you just got a bunch of kills in a row because their revenge is right around the corner. And they do team up. The terrain on these seven different multiplayer maps are huge and vary between buildings torn to shreds and canyons. This game was so fun I happened to play it for quite a while, so I have a lot of footage that I'll continue playing at the end of this video. This is Jet Car Stunts, pretty self-explanatory, just lots of this and more of this. It's an adrenaline rush. This is Geospark, one of the most addicting games I've ever played. Basically, you match the sparks. The longer you hold onto a spark, the more mass you have, attracting all of the other sparks to you. Touch the wrong spark with the one you have, and it's game over. My high score is 25,790. If you want, you can let me know in the comments if you beat it. I literally just installed Impossible Pixel last night. It's the closest thing in the App Store you can call a true platformer. Nothing like those free running apps that run for you, and all you do is touch anywhere on the screen to jump. There's actual skill involved here. Fantastic contraption. This game slash toy keeps my brain lubricated. The goal is to get the pink thing inside the other pink thing and be creative. Simple, right? It's got a huge database online full of maps other people have created, as well as their contraptions they use to beat the levels. Now we come to the most difficult game I've ever played. Vortex Rush. When I first played it, I didn't get a point. I closed the app right away out of anxiety and borderline depression. Maybe not that bad. It was pretty overwhelming though. A couple days later, I opened it back up and I figured it out. All you do is touch anywhere on the screen, but the length you hold down the screen determines the color. It's an overkill defender game. The title of this app is iBattle, but the game is originally called Strictico. It's very fun if you like a good challenge. It's a lot like chess, except you get to place your pieces wherever you want. It's also like capture the flag, because you try to protect your flag with bombs and intense strategies. And in case we ever play together, this is not one of my strategies. I just chose a preset strategy. Like in chess, there's interesting rules, like only threes, the miners, can defuse bombs. The spies are the only ones that can take out tens. The twos, or scouts, these are the only ones that can jump across the board. But once they do, they've revealed to the other player that there are two. You don't see the other player until you touch them or they touch you. Now this was an interesting part. A two actually attacked my eight, even though it knew I was an eight. That's because it knew I was about to get to the flag and it just had to try to distract me. It was kind of funny. I was just playing against a computer at that point. But you can play multiplayer either online, Bluetooth, local Wi-Fi, or using the same device. Chips Challenge. This was an old DOS game I used to play that's now under the title WebCC in the iOS App Store. The premise of the game is that high school nerd Chip McCallahan has met Melinda, the mental marvel, in the school science laboratory. He must navigate through Melinda's clubhouse, a series of increasingly difficult puzzles, in order to prove himself and gain membership to the very exclusive Bitbuster Club. I obviously did not make the cut. This is Cuvoid, another puzzle game in which you have six blank white sides that you can use only once to collect other colors and then match them to complete the level. Now this is my three little sisters' favorite game, Scribblenauts. You may have heard of it. It's a game in which you can type anything and it will become part of the game. Pretty much a sandbox to do whatever you want. There is a campaign mode, but I found it's just a lot of fun to play around with different items. The campaign just consists of different challenges and you just have to be creative to overcome them. You can add adjectives to your instructions to make new things. This is Bowman Attack. It's one of those games that will help you from being rude when your friends are over and you're just playing on your iPad. You can play with them, and it's turn-based, similar to the game Worms. Here's another one called Danger Alliance Battles, or DA Battles. Same concept. It's just in 3D and kind of like playing with toys that interact and try to kill each other. Here's another one that my 2-year-old sister knows how to grab my iPad, unlock it, find this app, and play it, and eggs on her 3-year-old sister to play with her. You just click the squares as they pop up that are your color. And I gotta say, adults get crazy with this game too, as there's no limit of how many hands can be on the screen at once. Now, I'm not a skateboarder, I'm more of a ripstick kind of guy. So I don't play this a lot, but I had to throw this in here because it's got nice baked textures and a really unique control scheme. Now, when I first played a game called Tiny Wings, which is very similar to this game, I was again intrigued by its control scheme. You just touch the screen anywhere to increase your mass and follow the ground, which you can strategically use to gain speed. Time Surfer takes it to another level, as it gives you the ability to rewind time. And I always choose a ducky as my companion because it has a super ability of giving you a second chance, which in this case didn't help me. I lost. Which isn't surprising since there's no end to this level and it's procedurally generated. Rovio Entertainment made another good choice when they implemented Star Wars into their Angry Birds game. This added a load of new mechanics to the scene. Beware of Payback 2, as its fun is glittered by lots of violence and gore. They sacrificed polygon count for good mechanics and pure fun. It has a DLC element to it, as the levels past the introductory levels you must buy. It also has a paid subscription multiplayer feature. Neither of which I got on board with, but that's up to you. I don't know what the whole big deal is about the zombie apocalypse, but I know I've played this game for hours. The name of the game is Zombie Gunship, in which you are a shooter, using precise attacks to defend citizens from hordes of zombies on their way to infiltrate your bunker, which is your goal to defend. If even one zombie gets through, the bunker shuts down and you move on to another location. It gets worse and worse as monsters are added to the mix, which are so difficult to defeat. And the end of it all, you always go home with a little bit of regret that you couldn't do more. Oh, no one got through! Now for a more peaceful game. Well, not exactly. In Euphloria, with an E, you colonize planets, some of which are already colonized. You take over the root system and grow your own trees that make more ships. One of the best games ever, let alone on iOS. Now seriously, this one is peaceful. It's called Osmos, and it was my first love when I got my first iPod Touch. You spit parts of yourself out, which make you smaller, as a form of locomotion. You can only eat things smaller than yourself, and of the same polarity. These green things are called antimatter, which you may remember from science class as negating regular matter. There's also sentient life forms, which make it a little bit more difficult to get your food, and a speed slider for those times when your patience has run out. And there's a variety of other games, like Sabotage, in which I spit onto the other one, forcing it to fall into the supermassive matter. Yet another game my 4-year-old sister can play. Not. Just by tilting the iPad, you can change the gravity and enjoy this interesting art style. And last but not least, Minecraft. The iOS release of this game is more of a fundraising stunt than the actual moddable, servable Minecraft as known by PC gamers worldwide. Don't normally play survival, but because of the limitations of the iOS platform, I did today, and it took me an hour to get these sheep in this fence. There is a creative mode, but you can't really serve it online like you can on the PC. And there's not much point to creating without sharing. Speaking of, we do have a server called SpicyNet. We've been working on for over a year. You're welcome to join us. If you'd like to be graylisted, just add me on Skype. My name is Dutails. Just say hi, and we'll see what we can do. Joyce seems to like that idea. I think I've proven myself as being one with the gamers. My three favorite things are building, exploring, and understanding. I do my best to chase those things. If I missed any must-have games or apps you'd like to share, let me know in the comment section. Now, as I promised, interruption-free Nova 3.